So how to check the broken links? How to check the broken links? By using script. How to check the broken links by using script? Okay. So first thing is, what is meant by broken link? What is meant by broken link? A link which is not working. Actually, broken links will be verified against the HTTP error codes. When you hit the URL, if the HTTP error code is 200, then URL is working. If HTTP error is other than 200, and if it is 300 plus or 400 or 500 plus, then the link is not working. Okay, so that's what that exactly the broken link meant. A link which is not working, then you call it as a broken link. Then, so one of the question that has been asked is, how do you verify the broken link? When I give a link, and then how do you check whether that link is working or not? Okay, right. So just let me take you an example. What is meant by that, and when you can say that link is not working? So to understand, the verifying the broken link, let's take two URLs. Okay, one is, we have this enterprise.demo.orangehrmlive.com, and which is not working. And the second one is, you say professional.demo.orangehrmlive.com, and which is working. Okay, so but not, I don't want to open that application, that URL in the browser. Without opening this, then I need to verify whether it is working or not. Okay, so remember, when the link is working, the HTTP error code will be 200 means it's working. Other than 200, if it is 400, 401, 402, 403, 404 like that, and 500, 501 like this, then there is a problem in the link, and that link is not working, and then you consider it as a broken link. Okay, now, so to check broken link using script, VBScript, then very first thing that what you need to do is, we need to create an object called msxml2, but we have different objects. Okay, so there is something called winhttp object also there. We can use either one, but right now winhttp is not working in my system because that DLL doesn't contain any class as of now, but later on I will show you that. But you can use something called msxml2.serverxmlhttp. Okay, so normally, this object is used to validating the URLs or sending the request to the servers without opening the application UI. Okay, so normally to send the request and all to the servers without opening the UI and all, normally we will be using this object. So whenever you want to create, whenever you want to check whether the link is working or not, then you need to create an object called msxml2.serverxmlhttp. Okay, and this object in the system, it will be using the DLL that's called as msxml6.dll. Okay, and this object will be using the class called serverxmlhttp. All the methods and all will be there in this particular class. Actually, they have defined in this class. Okay, so DLL is msxml6, which is in the system, but you will be having this DLL in your system, so that you will be able to use it. It will be there by default with all the operating systems that you will be getting, Windows operating system. Same thing, we normally, same DLL we have used for Microsoft.xml DOM. Okay, so this also from same DLL. Okay, so very first thing that you need to do that. Then once you create this object, what you have to do? There are always two things. you know, when you are doing this kind of testing, actually this also normally can refer to API testing. Okay, API. By using this technique, we also do the web service testing. What is mean by web services testing normally? Testing the application without having the interface. Okay, I will show you the web service also little later. Testing the application without having interface, that's called as a service API testing normally. So to do the API testing also normally we can use this. Okay, so when you are doing that, there will be two things, you know, normally we always call. One is you call it as a request, second one you call it as a response. Request means nothing but what you send to the server is a request. Response is what you receive from the server is a response. Got what I'm saying? Request and response. Okay. Now, once you create the object here, very first thing that what you need to do is you need to open the request. Okay. We need to open the request. So how do you open the request? That object dot, we have something called open method. Once you create the object, what you have to do? You need to open the request. Okay. We need to open the request. Now, once you open the, while opening the request, you need to specify few things. Okay. First one, you call it as a method. While opening the request, you need to tell the method, the type of request. Okay. Actually, there will be three types, but one normally you never use that. Okay, but those three types are like this. Get is one method. Post is one method. Header is one method. Okay, but header you eliminate as of now. But you will be having, normally we will be using two methods. One is get, second one is post. Okay. When do we use get? When do we use post? You say here, when you are just sending the URL without any data. Without any data in the sense, no data is being posted to the server. Your request contains no data, no inputs. In such cases, you can use get. Also, you can use post. Post can be used when you are sending the request without data or with data. But when you are sending the request with data, that means assume that you are sending an application form to the server. Using this, you are sending some application form or you are doing your file transfer, something that you are doing. That means with this request, you are transferring the data. Data transformations need to be happened from this client to the server. That means you need to transfer some data from here to server. In such cases, when you want to transfer the data, what you have to do? You have to use post. Okay. So post will be used when you are transferring the data, but unfortunately we will not be able to do it now because we need to define the data in an XML structure. All the services will be in the form of XMLs normally. Okay, all the services will be in the form of XML. So we need to define the XMLs normally, but as of now I'm not doing that. Okay, so as of now I'm not doing it. Just we will see it further. Get it what I'm saying? Okay, so next what I have to do is I need to define a method first. The method what I'm doing is I'm using get. It means I'm just, you know, posting the request without any data and getting the response from the server. That is the first one. Second one is the URL which you want to verify. The request, okay, so to which URL the request has to be sent. You provide the URL here. HTTP, say professional.demo.orangehrflive.com. The URL which needs to be tested or to which URL the request has to be sent. In case if you are doing a web service testing, you have to provide the URL of the web service here. I will talk about the web services slowly. Okay, so I will explain you that a web service contains normally a different URL, something called visdel, and slowly that I will tell you. So first two input is for open method get or post. Second one is URL. So if you are validating the URL, you need to give which URL you are validating here. Third one is, there is something called, you know, synchronous and asynchronous to transfer the data. You want to transfer the data in a synchronous way or asynchronous way. Normally you call it as. Normally what is meant by synchronous and asynchronous here? How the data has to be transformed. Okay, when you say asynchronous here, okay, so when the data is being transferred in an asynchronous way, data will be transferred bit by bit to the server. All data will get split into bitwise, and bit by bit data will be transferred. Synchronous in a sense, not bit by bit. Data will be transferred in the form of frames or forms. The old data will be transferred in a single frame. Getting what I'm saying? So when you use synchronous, old data will be transferred. But when you use asynchronous, bit by bit will be transferred. Ideally, synchronous will be too fast to transfer the data. Asynchronous will be bit slower. Also, for synchronous, there will be a specific time frame. Will be very quick. Generally, when we are doing live discussions and all, like chatting, data has to be transferred, the chat data, right? Or conferences, such kind of live discussions and all happening, then we will be using synchronous. But asynchronous means most of the time offline. When we are using offline data and all, then you can use asynchronous, like you say sending email. Then sending email in a sense may not be immediate delivery that happens, right? So it might take a little time. There is no particular time frame. Immediate transformation may not be done here, right? Or when you're doing blogging, when you do post in a blog, then what happens? It can take some time to post it. Such kind of situations, then normally we can use asynchronous. Okay, just you have to specify true or false here. True means you are specifying you can transfer this in asynchronous way. False means transfer it in synchronous way. But that is optional. Okay, because anyway we are not sending any data right here. Since we are not sending any data, then you don't need to give that. And the fourth input and fifth input are username and password. That means if that URL requires any credentials. If that URL requires any credentials, right? Then probably you need to give the username and password, right? Because you see some URLs, as soon as you hit the URL, it will force you to give the username and password to open that URL. If you don't give the username and password, that URL doesn't get open, will not be able to validate. So if the URL needs any username and password to get it opened, then we can use, we need to provide username and password here. Okay. So create object of msxml2.serverxmlhttpobject. So once you create that object, what you have to do? You need to open the request. After opening the request, what you have to do? You need to send it. You just opened it now and you need to send the request. Now you say send. Send means sending the request. Okay. Now here what you can do, in case if you are sending with the data, that means if you have given post here and you have a data need to be transferred, data should be defined in the form of XML. You can give that XML here. Okay. In case if you are transferring the data, what you can do, you can send the data in the form of XML. Okay, getting what I'm saying? Next. Once you send the request, what you have to do? You need to check for the response. You need to check for the response. But before we get the response, it might take a little time to do the data transfer and receiving the response, right? send the request and receiving the response. So that's the reason what you have to do is you need to wait till the response is completely transferred here, right? Till we receive the response completely. That's called ready state. Usually you call it as a ready state. You already know what is meant by in the DOM. We have seen that already, right? Okay, now you have something called ready state. Now, ready state has got different statuses like 1, 2, 4, like that. 4 means response completely received. Okay, request and the transformation has been completely done. That means ready. 4 means. 1 means busy, still loading, still the response is being received or request is being sent. So 1 is being busy. So what you have to do here? You have to wait till the response is 4. I mean, sorry, ready state is 4 here. Then what I do is I'll say like this: int response code or response code equal to. Then I will keep this in a loop because keep looping if int response code equal to 4. Then exit to do. That means what it has to do? It has to keep looping till when? Till ready state becomes 4. Right? So while the response code is not 4, then it will be looping. Right? Getting what I'm saying here? Next. Once the response is completed, once it receives the response completely, now we need to check the status code. If the URL is working, server will respond with status code 200. HTTP code will be 200. If the URL is not working, then HTTP error code will be maybe different. HTTP error code 500 or 400, like that, right? Now, you say this. Int HTTP error equal to OXML dot. You say status. You have two things, status and status text. Status means code number. Error number that it will give you. Status text means description of the error. Okay. So now you can just say int HTTP error. You can say like this: if HTTP error equal to 200, then message box is, yeah, link is working. Else message box, you say that link is not working, error description, what you can do here, OXML dot status text. Okay, now, so what you can do is you can just store here and I'll just save this. Let me just execute that now. It says 200. and it's a link is working, right? Okay, now same thing that what I do is I'll say enterprise. Okay, enterprise. It is 500. Then link is not working. Error description, internal server error. The link is not working. Got what I'm saying? So you can see this is how normally you can check whether a link is working or not. Right? Now, you can give some other errors also. I will tell you some other errors here. You have like this admin. I'm just logging into the application. So now you just say any of this link. I'll just go to add employee here. Copy this one. I'll just paste this URL. It's working, right? I'll just change the URL. Employee 1 I will give. It says that invalid request. That means link is not working, right? So that means it's not able to send the response. Sorry, it's server says that, okay, so the request whatever you have sent or the URL is wrong. So I'm just validating it now. The link which is not working. Or not found. It says URL not found. Okay. So this is how normally you can check the broken link. So how do you verify the broken link with VBScript? How do you verify the broken link with VBScript? Got? Okay, now let's extend this. Let's extend this requirement. So in interview, what they will be asking is, what they will ask is, I have some links in the page. I have some links in the page. I want to verify how many links working and how many links not working in that. In a page, in a particular page, I need to verify the broken links, right? So how do you do that? Yeah, you can do that. You can convert into a function and then you can verify it. Yeah, so first what you need to do, first you need to get the collection of the links, then for each link, what you have to do, you need to get the href. Right? Href represents the URL to which URL it has to head to. And then next, what you have to do, take the URL and every URL you need to pass here. So, but you can convert into the function, no problem. Right? Okay. So what you can do is here. You can say like this. First, you say set O description equal to. I'm just writing in VBS edit, but you need to write the same thing in EFT, right? Then you say O disk dot add. You can say mic class as link, right? Then set O link collection equal to. Browser of some browser dot page of some page dot child objects of odisk. That gives the collection of all the links. Then you can say for I equal to 0 to olink collection dot count minus 1. is a O-link collection of I dot getRO property of href. What this does? Get the URL of the link. Then you say str URL. Also, you can do this. Str link name equal to olink collection of I dot get RO property of text. Right? Now, what you can do here? You can just make this as a function. Check link str URL. Str link name, just I will write here. This one, what you can do, you can give URL here. And during the report, right, you can say link str link name. Say so and so link is not working. Then what you can do, you can just say this as end function. But in fact, you know, instead of message box, you can write a report also. Right? So you can do this. And then what you can do, call check link of str URL comma str link. So what this does now, it will verify all the links in the page. So how do you check the broken links in a page? Getting what I'm saying? So the question might come like this. I have some links in a page, but I don't know how many are there, but I just want to verify which link working in that and which link is not working. But manually, if you open in each browser, right, you open the browser and then you navigate, it takes a lot of time in fact. But this is the simple way. Now no need to open any browser to check the link. Right? So this is how normally you can check the broken links using the script. One of the very, very important thing that you will be doing.